Okay, so Miss Ulang Semula. So in this chapter, we have three subtopics. So for today, today's class, untuk jam yang pertama ni, Miss akan cover satu subtopik sahaja, 7.1, gravitational force and field strength. So ada dua learning outcome di sini. Okay, we have first, state and use Newton's law of gravitation. Second is define and use gravitational field strength. So kita ada dua benda yang kita akan tengok. Satu Newton's law of gravitation, satu lagi gravitational field strength. Okay, dalam video lecture, kita sudah cover the first part of the learning outcome, which is to state what is Newton's law of gravitation. And then to define what is the gravitational field strength. Okay, so just a little bit of recap here. Newton's law of gravitation. Okay, yang kita tahu, so any object or every object in the universe, okay, will attract each other, okay, will attract every other particle. So bermaksud dekat sini, kalau kita ada dua objek, okay, di at separate distance, at a distance maybe 2 meter, so these two object will attract each other. Bermaksud di sini, so daripada objek yang pertama, okay, dia akan ada force, okay, force towards the object, the second object, and daripada objek yang kedua, dia akan ada force towards the first object. So they akan attract each other. So this is what the Newton's law of gravitation. So this force is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Ataupun kita boleh translate kepada formula ni, di mana force, okay, the force between them is directly proportional to the product of the mass, okay, product of their masses. So mass 1 dan mass 2, okay, product dia, dan inversely proportional with the distance, okay, the square of the distance. So the distance between this. So if dekat sini, okay, kalau dalam chapter 7 ni kita banyak tengok forces between planet actually. So so kalau between planet, kita akan ambil dia punya distance ni, okay, dia punya distance ni kita akan ambil daripada the center of the planet, okay, the center of the planet to the other center of the planet. Kita tidak boleh ambil dia daripada sini ke sini. So this one is not the distance, dia mesti daripada center. Okay, so this is the formula for the gravitational force, di mana G dekat sini adalah the gravitational constant. So this is the value of the gravitational constant, 6.67 exponent negative 11 Newton per meter square per kg square. And then the mass here is just the product of the mass of the two objects. And then R is the distance between particles. So R here, okay, you don't get confused with radius. Dia sebenarnya bukanlah radius, dia adalah distance. But we still use the symbol R. Okay, so force, obviously, dia punya unit adalah Newton. Okay, so this is just a recap for the Newton's law of gravitation. Any questions so far?
Miss.
Yes?
Kenapa yang distance between particles tu boleh R square di bawah?
Kenapa boleh R square? Okay, yeah, that one is, kita kena tanya Isaac Newton kali tu lah. Kenapa boleh R square? That one I'm not really sure. Sebab Newton's law of gravitation memang dia cakap macam tu. F2, force 2, dia mesti inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them.
Oh, okay, Miss.
Okay. So that one, okay, I'm sorry, I'm not sure. Maybe if there is an answer to that, then I'll get back to you later.
Okay, Miss, thank you.
Okay, alright. So now, kita tahu force, dia adalah directly proportional to the product of mass, but inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So now kita akan tengok hubungan antara force dengan the distance. Okay, so kalau daripada sini kita tahulah, if the distance is higher, okay, semakin jauh dua objek ataupun particle, okay, force between them will be lower. Okay, disebabkan dia dekat sini square, So we look at this gravitational force, a gravitational force with the separation. So this graph here. So if the force is F, just one F, and then the radius is just one R, or sorry, the distance is just one R. So if we double the distance between the two objects, so this is the object, let's say like this is the two object. So initially distance between these two object is just R, and then force in between them is just F. And now we want to double the distance. So kita letak dia jauh sedikit, double lah. Dia mesti double the distance. So if we double the distance, what happened to the force? Okay, dia akan, force ni akan kurang sebanyak 1 over 4 from the initial force. Okay, because daripada sini kita dapat R square kan, R square. So kalau kita kira dia, dia akan jadi 1 over 4. The 1 over 4 from the initial force. Okay, this one kalau kita tidak nak, kita tidak gunakan value of the force lah. Just as the concept here. So maksudnya kalau kita tambah lagi value of R tu, okay, 3R from the initial one, so force tu dia akan decrease by 1 over 9. Okay, so this is just to see the relationship between the force and the distance. So semakin jauh antara dua objek, okay, dua particle, force between them will be lower. Okay, will decrease. Okay, boleh?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh.
Okay, so next one is the gravitational field strength. So this is the second learning outcome. So gravitational field strength, ataupun kita panggil dia sebagai gravitational acceleration. Ini adalah value untuk gravity. Okay, so by definition, gravitational field strength is the gravitational force per unit mass of a body ataupun test mass placed at a point. Ataupun kita boleh cakap dia sebagai dalam formula. So the gravitational field strength, okay, kita gunakan simbol AG. Okay, sebab dia adalah acceleration. Adalah sama dengan force per unit mass. Per unit mass. Force divided by mass. So force di sini adalah force of the gravitational. Okay, which is the one here. This one. So apabila kita masukkan this one, this formula to here, so kita akan dapat formula untuk gravitational field strength is equal to gm divided by r squared. So here m, okay, m is the mass of the mass of a body of a planet. Okay, so sama juga g adalah gravitational constant. So mass is the mass of the, so this one is test mass, and then r is still the distance between a point and a mass. And then the unit here, okay, since unit untuk force adalah Newton, and then mass adalah kg, so kita akan dapat Newton per kg. Ataupun kita boleh gunakan meter per second square. Okay, sebab dia adalah acceleration. So value untuk gravity kita tahu dia adalah 9.81 meter per second square. Okay, so here, okay, this one lah. So just to see if you understand the concept here or not. Wait. Okay, so kita tahu, so bumi ni dia akan ada gravitational fields. Okay, gravitational field, which is going towards the center. Ni adalah field. Okay, going towards the center of the earth. Okay, now, okay, let's consider a situation here. If I have two particles, okay, if I have two particles, particles A and B, and then these two particles have the same mass. So mass of A sama dengan mass of B. So let's say if I place the particle A here, particle B, okay, maybe here. Okay, which particle will have a stronger or will experience a stronger gravitational field?
A,
right? Because kita tahu A will increase when the distance decrease, right? So semakin dekat dia dengan permukaan bumi, semakin tinggilah, semakin kuatlah dia punya gravitational field strength. Okay, so that's the first situation. Okay, now if I let me padam dulu. Oops. Okay, so now if I say that mass of A is larger than mass of B, and then mis letaklah dekat sini particle A, dekat sini particle B. Okay, which one will experience a greater gravitational field?
A juga.
Why?
Sebab lagi tinggi mass, lagi tinggi force.
This one is not force, Miss bercakap tentang gravitational field strength.
Yep, mass strength.
For AG. So kalau kedua-dua partikel ni dekat tempat yang sama, maksudnya distance sekarang ni samalah. Mereka punya distance sama, tetapi partikel A ni dia lebih berat daripada partikel B. So kamu cakap partikel A will experience a greater gravitational field strength. Maksudnya dekat sini AG dia adalah decrease lah, maksud kamu tu kan? Tu yang kamu faham kan?
Ya, yeah, Miss.
Ya. Yeah.
Okay, so kita tengok semula dekat sini, dekat formula ni. So formula di sini, kita boleh nampak kalau kalau distance tu decrease, this one akan increase. And then, kita boleh nampak juga, okay, acceleration ni increase if the mass, okay, if the mass here increase. Okay, but the mass here is not the mass of the object. Mass dekat sini adalah the test mass. Maksudnya mass of the planet. Okay, so mass of the planet. Apa maksud dia? Di sini, okay, tak kisahlah kita letak dia di mana-mana. Tak kisahlah partikel tu ada berbeza berat, mass dalam berbeza. Tetapi kalau distance sama, okay, dia punya gravitational field strength is still the same. Sebab dekat dalam formula dia AG is equal to GM divided by R squared, di mana M dekat sini adalah mass of a body ataupun test mass. Test mass ni adalah the planet. Okay, this one is the mass of the point mass. So maksudnya di sini, okay, maksudnya dekat sini kan, mass tu tidak akan mempengaruhi acceleration, tidak akan mempengaruhi gravitational field strength. Sama lah, kita kan semua dekat permukaan bumi. Adakah Miss punya gravitational field strength berbeza dengan kamu? Tidak kan? Sebab tidak. Semua akan experience the same gravitational acceleration, tidak, which is 9.81. Okay, boleh faham tu di situ? So dia berbeza. Acceleration dengan force tidak sama. So acceleration, mass, okay, mass of a particle does not influence the acceleration. But force will influence. So meaning that here, if I say, still the same, mass of the particle A is larger than mass of the particle B. So dekat sini, force of the particle A will be larger. Tetapi, acceleration of A akan sama dengan acceleration of B. Oh, sorry. Eh. Okay, so force dia akan mempengaruhi okay, berat sesuatu partikel. Tetapi acceleration tidak akan mempengaruhi. Yang mempengaruhi adalah distance sahaja. Boleh faham tu?
Boleh, Miss.
Okay, so you need to...
Boleh, Miss.
Always keep in mind that okay, the gravitational force is independent. So is independent of mass of a particle ataupun object. Okay, any questions so far?
Tak ada.
Ada soalan?
Tiada, Miss.
Tiada, Miss.
So Miss boleh terus masuk dalam bincang calculation? Soal example boleh?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh. Boleh, Miss.
Okay, kita akan tengok example ya. Okay, dalam nota kamu ada example satu, tetapi example satu tu hanya basic saja macam mana menggunakan formula. Tapi sebab that one is straight away, so Miss tidak mau bincanglah example tu. Kita terus tengok example yang kedua di sini. Okay, di mana kita boleh cover learning outcome yang kedua. Okay, so first here, let's read the question. So we have, okay, calculate the net force on the moon due to the gravitational attraction of both the Earth and the Sun if the moon is between the Earth and the Sun, which is during solar eclipse, and if they are at right angles to each other, which is during the first quarter moon. And then we are given the constant here, mass of the moon, mass of the Earth, mass of the Sun, and then the distance. Okay, so first thing, what do we need to do? Apa yang kita perlu buat first sekali?
Keluarkan information.
Keluarkan information. So apa information yang kita ada? Kita ada semua ni. Okay, lagi ada lagi information lain?
Moon is between the Earth and Sun.
So moon is between the Earth and Sun. Okay, so macam Miss cakap sebelum ni, kita always kalau mau solve the question, we always lukis. Kita mesti lukis dahulu so that kita nampak. So now kita lukislah situation di mana moon is between the Earth and the Sun. Okay, so let's say this is the Earth and then this is the moon. So moon is in between and then this is the Sun. Nampak kata? Okay, so maybe this is the Sun lah. So they are all okay, in line. But this is what happened during the solar eclipse. So moon is in between the Earth and the Sun here. Okay, so now soalan minta adalah the net force on the moon. So maksudnya kita mau net force dekat dekat bulan sahaja. Okay, dekat sini dengan dekat sini kita tidak mau. So hanya dekat bulan. So whenever there is a word net force, bermaksud okay, hasil tambah force. Sum of the force. Net force adalah sum of the force. Okay, so here, so we know that the distance between all of these planets are from the center of the of each planet. So here, wait, let me do this one first. So there is a distance here. This one here. Okay, let's say lah, this one adalah R1, this one R2. Okay, di mana distance daripada Earth? Okay, let me label here Earth, Moon, and Sun. So from the Earth to the Moon, the this is the distance, 3.84 exponent 5 kilometer. And then the Sun's the distance from the Moon to the Sun is this one. Okay, so because we want to find the net force on the Moon. Okay, can I have Isham boleh bagi tahu Miss? Okay, apa force yang ada dekat Moon ni?
FB itu lah.
Apa dia?
Force dari sun punya gravitation dengan Earth.
Force dari sun. And then?
Dengan Earth.
Sorry, dengan apa?
Dengan bumi.
Dengan Earth, okay. So kita akan ada dua force lah kan di sini. Satu force daripada sun. Satu force daripada Earth. Okay, so here kita akan ada dua force. Okay, kita tahu Earth juga akan ada force sebab dia akan, there will, these two planet will attract each other. Okay, tetapi sebab sekarang ni kita hanya concern kepada moon sahaja. Okay, so only on moon. So kita hanya tengok, kita hanya label dekat moon saja. So here we have the force, okay, to the sun on the moon. This one FEM. Okay, the force from the earth to the moon. Okay, kalau mau terbalik pun dapat, it's okay actually. Doesn't matter lah, yang penting kamu tahu akan ada force daripada earth, akan ada force daripada moon, daripada sun. Dan juga moon akan bagi force kepada sun. Okay, so now, because we want the net force, which is the sum of F, acting on the moon. So here, bermaksud kita akan kena tambah kedua-dua force ni. Okay, disebabkan force ni adalah vector quantity. So you need to take into account the direction. So, we always follow the sun convention, pergi kanan positif, pergi kiri negatif. So pergi kanan, this one here, based on kita punya lukisan ni lah, yang pergi kanan adalah FSM. So dia akan jadi positif. So pergi kiri, FEM. So dia akan jadi negatif. Okay, so in order to find the net force, kita kena cari individual force dahulu. So let's find FSM first, which is the force, okay, by the sun. So here, gunakan formula GMSMM divided by R2. So mass of the sun times with mass of the moon divided by R2, which is here, the distance between the two of them. Okay, and then you just masukkanlah formula value di mana G adalah 6.67 exponent negative 11. So this one adalah constant value. Kamu tidak perlu ingat pun tidak apa. And then mass of the sun. So mass of the sun is this one, 1.99 exponent 30. And then mass of the moon is this one, 7.35 exponent 22 divided by, and this one don't forget the square, so divided by the distance between them, the sun and the moon, 1.5 exponent 8 kilometer. So kilometer always convert to SI unit, which is meter. So 1.50 exponent berapa sah? Exponent 8. Okay, kilometer you need to convert to meter, then square. Okay, tolong tekan calculator.
Four point three four exponent twenty.
Okay, thank you, Amin. Okay, 20 newton. Okay, don't forget the unit. Okay, so that's the first one. Now kita akan kira this one. Semua dapat kan? Is it the same value that you get?
Yeah.
Yes, miss.
Okay, so next one. Okay, FEM. So G, mass of the earth, and mass of the moon, divided by the distance between them and then square. So you masukkan 6.67 exponent negative 11 and then mass of the earth is 5.98 exponent 24 and then mass of the moon 7.35 exponent 22 and then divided by the distance between them, which is this one, 3.84 exponent 5 and then convert to meter and then square. Okay, dekat sini kamu kena selalu hati-hati ya, sebab kita menggunakan eksponen yang value yang tinggi. Ada 11, ada 24. So kadang-kadang tekan calculator tu make sure kamu kena double check. Kamu kadang-kadang ada yang tekan 2 je, 4 dekat sini dia tertinggal. So always double check. Okay, whenever kita guna kita buat calculation yang melibatkan eksponen. Okay, kalau sudah dapat, give me the answer.
1.988 exponent 20.
1.988 exponent 20 Newton. Okay, so now kita sudah dapat these two value of the force. So now we can find the net force using this one. So wait, let me. So the net force is equal to FSM minus FEM. So FSM adalah this one, 4.34 exponent 20. And then minus 1.988 exponent 20 Newton. So sama dengan
2.352 exponent 20 Newton.
Semua dapat?
Dapat miss.
Okay, so sekarang ni sebab dia minta net force, okay, maksudnya kamu kena bagi both magnitude and direction. So now we have the magnitude. So how can we identify the direction here?
Tangent theta.
Tangent theta, perlukah tangent theta?
The sign in front of the force.
Okay, the sign in front of the force. Sebab sekarang ni kita punya vector adalah on the x-axis only. Okay, x component. Tiada y component. So tidak perlu buat calculation yang tangent tu. So now, because it is only on the x component, kita akan tengok the sign here. So sign dekat sini kamu memang dapat positif kan semua?
Yeah, miss.
So semua akan dapat positif. So kalau positif bermaksud the direction will be
to the right.
To the right here. Maksudnya towards the sun. So you can say will be towards the sun. Okay, better tulis specific lah towards the sun instead of kamu cakap to the right. Okay, mesti specific dekat sini towards the sun. Sebab contohlah kalau kamu punya lukisan tu, contoh kamu tidak lukis di dalam semasa exam, kamu tidak lukis. So the pemeriksa dia tidak akan tahu sun kamu ni ke mana. Adakah di sebelah kanan ataupun di sebelah kiri. That's why kamu kena tulis specific towards the sun. So kalau sun kita lukiskan, matahari dekat sini, earth dekat sini, terbalik. So in the end nanti kita buat calculation, dia still sama. Kita akan dapat negatif, which is negatif tu towards the sun. So kalau kamu letak to the left, we don't know. To the left tu dia ke mana sebenarnya. Adakah towards the earth ataupun towards the sun. So whenever we have this kind of question, bila kita dah spesifikkan benda tu, so you spesifikkanlah direction tu towards the sun. Boleh?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Okay. Boleh, Miss.
So, can I continue to the next one? Question B?
Yes, Miss.
Okay, kalau yes, Miss. Cepat, bagi yes, tahu miss. Ya. Okay, so now question B. So, sama juga, we still need to calculate the net force, but now our situation is when they are at right angles at each other. So, ketiga-tiga ni mesti right angles at each other. Okay, so now okay, apabila right angle, sebab kita mahu, sebab soalan minta the net force on the moon, masih on the moon. So we can only draw it like this, di mana this is the moon, okay, this is the sun, this is the earth. Okay, so moon, sun, sorry, this one sun, one earth. So daripada sini kita boleh nampak mereka adalah right angle to each other. This is the only situation yang kita boleh buatlah di mana mereka adalah right angle. So wait. Okay, because situation dia soalan dia minta situation macam ni. So here okay, dia sama juga di mana moon ni dia akan ada force towards the sun, which is FSM, then towards the earth, FEM. Okay, adakah force dekat sini berbeza? Berbeza ke sama?
Sama.
Sama, kenapa sama? Macam mana kamu tahu sama?
Ikut pengiraan di atas tu.
Ya, yeah, towards the force juga.
They still towards the force. Yang lain, ada idea kenapa kita punya force still sama?
Pasal dia punya radius sama.
Okay, sebab distance between these two still sama. Kita tidak cakap dia makin jauh. Kan? So, dia masih lagi sama. So, kalau sama, force akan sama. Okay, this value still the same. But now, the net force is different. So how to find this net force?
Magnitude.
Okay, kita kena cari magnitude because this one sebenarnya dia sudah akan jadi vector dekat sini. So the net force is here. This is the net force. So here net force is equal to FSM square plus FEM square. Okay, so since force dia still sama, so kita gunakan value yang kita sudah kira tadi dekat soalan A, which is FSM tadi berapa? 4.34 exponent 20 square plus 1.988 exponent 20 square. And then don't forget the square root and then you will get the net force
4.77 exponent 20.
4.77
exponent 20.
Exponent 20. Okay, thank you, Azmi. Exponent 20. Semua dapat jawapan yang sama?
Dapat, Miss.
Dapat, Miss. Dapat, Miss.
Okay. Ada soalan so far?
Tiada.
Tiada. Semua okay?
Okay, Miss.
Okay. So, kita boleh continue the next example?
Can.
Boleh.
So, next example 3. But let me copy this one first. Okay, so here example 3. So example 3 masih lagi di subtopic 7.1A di mana kita akan tengok gravitational force. Okay, let's read the question first. A 200 kg object and a 500 kg object are separated by 4 meter. Okay, find the net gravitational force exerted by these objects on a 50 kg object placed midway between them. Okay, so kita ada dua objek dengan mass yang berbeza. Okay, dan kedua-dua objek ni, okay, the distance between them two is 4 meter. Okay, so kita lukis dahulu. So kita ada objek yang pertama. Okay, objek ni tak kisahlah, Miss buat bulat saja supaya senang. Ini adalah objek yang kedua. So this one pertama, this one yang kedua, di mana kita akan letaklah yang pertama tu adalah 200 kg. Yang kedua adalah 500 kg. And the distance between them, so the distance between them is 4 meter. Okay, now find the net gravitational force by these objects on a 50 kg object placed midway between them. So kita ada another object, di mana objek ni adalah 50 kg dan diletakkan di tengah-tengah. Okay, dia masih midway between them. So let's say it is here. So this object, yang ketiga lah. Yang ketiga ni mass dia adalah 50 kg. And then it is midway. So meaning that from here to here. So from here to here adalah sama dengan daripada sini ke sini, which is 2 meter each. And what we want is the net gravitational force. So sama juga net gravitational force macam soalan yang tadi, di mana okay, dekat objek ni akan ada force. Okay, akan ada force. So kita label dia 1, 2 dan 3 kan. So dia akan ada force daripada 3, daripada 1 on 3, and then force daripada 2 ke 3. Okay, so it's still the same.
No, because the mass.
Because what?
The mass of the objects is not the same.
Yes, the mass of the object is not the same. So it's not. So force dekat sini dan dekat sini akan berbeza. So now, soalan yang sama juga macam yang tadi, di mana the sum of the force, which is equal to, okay, equal to, so F23 ke kanan dia akan jadi positif, tambah dengan, negatif, tolak dengan F13. Okay, dia sebenarnya adalah tambah sebab dia adalah sum. Sum maksudnya tambah. So this one will be negative. F13 sebab dia to the left, so it will be negative. Okay, dia akan jadi macam ni. Okay, so kalau kamu mau buat macam yang tadi, di mana kita akan cari satu-satu pun boleh, ataupun terus selesaikan dalam ni pun boleh. So sekarang ni kita mau buat, kita terus selesaikan. Cara yang cepat lah. So now kita akan masukkan GM2 M3 divided by R23 minus, okay, minus GM1 M3 divided by R13. So this is R13, R23. Okay, so this one lebih cepat sebab okay, value yang berbeza tadi macam yang Jason cakap tadi lah. Value yang berbeza di sini adalah the mass. Okay, the mass here, this one. These two value is different. So yang lain semua sama. So kita boleh faktorkan, tidak perlu okay, mau salin banyak kali. So kita faktorkan yang sama, which is value for G, and then value for the mass, which is mass dekat sini. What is it? 50. Okay, 50 kg divided by these two value pun sama. Right. Dia adalah kedua-duanya 2 meter. So 2 meter. And then 1 wait. And then M3 adalah, what is the mass 3? Sorry, mass 2, 500. 500 minus 200. Okay, sorry, I forgot the square here. Square. Okay, kalau ada tersilap, bagi tahu Misa. 6.6750. Okay, cuba tekan kalkulator.
2.5 exponent negative 7.
2.5 exponent negative 7 Newton. Okay, so the direction here. What is the direction?
To the right.
Yeah.
To the right, which is towards?
M2.
Towards M2. Towards M2. Okay, sebab dia adalah positif, kamu dapat value positif kan? So towards M2, to the right. Okay, any question?
Miss.
Yeah?
Yang Miss kasih keluar tu yang M3 bahkan?
Yes, M3. This one. Sebab kedua-duanya ada M3. Okay, sorry. Tersilap. So yang berbeza adalah M2 di sini. So yang lain semua sama.
Okay, Miss. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, so boleh continue to the next one?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Okay, boleh. So boleh, kita boleh tengok soalan B. So at what position can the 50 kg object be placed so as to experience a net force of zero from the other two objects? Okay, let me, Aiman ada? Aiman, are you there? Aiman, tiada. Wait, siapa lagi ni? Andi. Andi ada? Andi tiada juga. Andi ada, boleh dengar Andi?
Ada, Miss.
Okay, Andi. So, soalan B di sini, apa yang kamu faham dia minta sebenarnya? Apa situation dia di sini, soalan B ni?
Dekat position mana?
Ya. Yeah.
Objek yang 50 kilo tu, dia punya net force.
Punya net force?
Zero.
Okay, dia punya net force zero. Okay, so sekarang ni, okay, thank you Andy. So sekarang ni, kita punya objek ni, objek yang ketiga ni, yang 50 kg ni, dia dekat point 2 meter daripada objek 1 dan 2 meter daripada objek 2. Maksudnya dia di tengah-tengah. So apabila dia di tengah-tengah, kita dapat net force dia ada value, which is this value yang kita dapat tadi. So now, kita mau gerakkan kita, objek ni. Kita mau gerakkan, we don't know where, but kita kena gerakkan di mana satu point tu dia akan, okay, dia punya net force ni akan jadi sama dengan kosong. Okay, so now let me padam dulu here.
Gerak ke kanan.
So dia either kita akan gerak dia lah, maybe ke kanan, then dekat point sini dia akan jadi kosong, or maybe ke kiri, we don't know. Okay, let's say last kali ni, we don't know the value, right? So dia punya distance sekarang kita tidak tahu. Sebab itulah yang kita akan kira. So the distance here, okay, let's say kita akan letak value, okay, kat sini lah R2, 3. So dekat sini akan jadi sama dengan 4 meter minus R2, 3. Okay, boleh nampak kat tu? Sebab kita tahu, okay, wait. Okay, macam tu lah. Kita tahu macam ni kan? R13 tambah R23 adalah still sama dengan 4 meter. Dia still, kedua-dua ni, distance dia adalah 4 meter. Tetapi, distance objek yang ketiga ni yang kita tidak tahu. Distance dia daripada sini dan daripada sini. So now we can say that R13 plus pi 2 3 is equal to 4. Okay, 4 meter. So meaning that R 1 3 is equal to 4 minus R 2 3. Okay, boleh faham macam mana Miss dapat ni? Ada yang tidak faham?
Boleh Miss.
Boleh Miss.
Boleh kan? Okay. So now kita sudah dapat ni. And what we want here is this, okay, this value to be zero. So we're still using the same equation here, but now this one will be zero. So here, the sum of F is equal to F, berapa saya tadi tu? F 2 3 minus F 1 3. So now dia akan jadi sama dengan kosong di sini. So meaning that we can equate them both, di mana F 2 3 is equal to F 1 3. Okay, so this is the value that we want to find, these two value yang kita mau cari, sebab dia tanya at what position, maksudnya distance daripada either daripada sini ataupun daripada sini. Okay, so now we just masukkan formula di mana GM2M3 divided by R 2 3 equal to GM 1 M 3 divided by R 1 3 square. Okay, and this is what we want to find. Okay, since kita ada benda ni tadi, here, this one. Let me copy first. Since kita sudah keluarkan, so kita boleh substitute R13 to this value. Okay, so this one kita boleh cancel benda yang sama. So we're left with M2 divided by R23 square equal to M1 divided by 4 minus R23 square. Okay, betul kami sebut ni?
So far, rasa betul.
So far, rasa betul.
Okay. So far, okay Miss.
So far, okay. Kita masuklah terus kan M2 ni. M2 berapa tadi? M2 dan M1. M2
500 kg.
So M1 200. Let me double check. M1 200, M2 500. Okay. So now, macam mana mau selesaikan? This one, okay, mathematics sudah ni. So kita akan selesaikan yang paling senang dekat sini. Okay, macam mana yang paling senang? Anyone ada idea yang paling senang macam mana? Cara untuk selesaikan?
Darab silang.
Darab silang.
Darab okay. Silang.
Yes. So darab silang 4 minus R 2 3 square divided by R 2 3 square equal to 200 divided by 500. Okay, and then because atas bawah kita ada square, so we can just hapuskan, which kita akan square root both sides. Oops. So square root both sides, so kita akan dapat like this one here. So here you will get 1.5 at 1. I think you will get, is it? Betulkah? Okay, tidak. Okay, cuba kira this one. Dapat berapa?
Kosong point enam tiga.
Okay. So now, temukan 0.63. Wait, macam mana satu? 4 minus R23 equal to 0.63 R23. So you will get R23 equal to 2.45 meter. Semua dapat 2.45 meter.
Dapat, miss.
Okay. So, dekat sini jawapan dia adalah 1.55 meter kan? Okay. Sebab soalan ni dia tidak minta position ni daripada mana? Adakah daripada objek 1 ataupun objek 2? So kalau kamu punya jawapan 2.45 meter pun boleh sebab kita tahu KR13 adalah, okay, tadi kita dapat R23, right? So R13 here is 4 meter minus 2.45 meter, which is you will get 1.55 meter. R13. So kamu akan dapat 1.55 meter. Okay, sebab disebabkan soalan ni dia tidak minta objek ni location dia daripada mana. Adakah daripada objek 2 ataupun objek 1. Dia tidak spesifikkan. So kalau kamu leave the answer as 2.45 pun betul. Okay, so but to be safe kita letaklah dua-dua jawapan. Kita letak 2.45 ataupun dan juga 1.55. Okay, tetapi ada certain soalan dia minta. Okay, what is the position of the object from mass 2? Okay, from the second object. So, kalau that one, you need to specify lah, which is kamu kena leave it the answer as this value of R23. Boleh?
Boleh, miss.
Okay. Boleh, I know miss. It's almost 1 o'clock, tapi sebab petang ni kita punya kelas juga kan? So boleh kami sambil masak kamu sikit untuk siapkan, habiskan? Example.
Boleh, miss.
Okay, so sebab ada satu lagi example. Dan macam yang miss janji, kita akan buat quiz lepas ni. Okay, so before miss masuk the next example, ada soalan untuk example 3?
Tiada, miss.
Tiada, semua okay?
Jelas,
okay, good.
Okay, miss.
Okay, kita akan tengok example 4. Okay, di mana example 4 ni adalah the question, okay, berkenaan dengan gravitational field strength. So the second learning outcome, okay, learning outcome yang B. Okay, so let's read the question. Okay, determine the magnitude of the gravitational field strength at a point, okay, 500 kilometer above the Earth's surface and on the Earth's surface. Okay, so this one straightforward saja sebenarnya. So kita ada planet yang terlibat dekat sini adalah Earth, and then we want to find what is the gravitational field strength dekat satu point, di mana point tu adalah, let's say lah dekat point ni, di mana point ni adalah 5,000 kilometer, okay, above the Earth surface. So we want to find the gravitational field strength, and then dia minta magnitude saja, so you don't need to include the direction. Okay, so this one gunakan formula kgm divided by r square, di mana r square here, okay, r here will be the distance, okay, from the center of the planet ataupun from the Earth lah. So this is the value for r. So ni adalah point dia lah. Let's say lah miss letak point A. Okay, so m dekat sini adalah mass of the planet. So here sangat simple. You just masukkan, okay, the constant value and then the mass of the Earth, which is this one here, 5.98 exponent 24 divided by the distance. So distance, radius of the Earth tambah dengan, okay, the distance of the point. So 5,000 kilometer convert to meter. Okay, tambah dengan radius of the Earth, which is this one. It's already in meter. And then square kan.
Three point zero eight
meter per second squared. Okay, so since they meter magnitude saja, you don't need to include the direction. But do you know where is the direction? Kalau lah soalan dia minta, direction dia ke mana?
To the earth.
Towards okay, the to, earth.
Towards the center. They mesti include center. Towards the center of the earth. Okay, kalau soalan minta direction, then you need to say towards this center of the earth. But soalan hanya minta magnitude, so tidak perlu include pun tidak apa. Okay, so next question. Okay, sama juga, we need to find the gravitational field strength, but now on the earth surface. So ngam-ngam dekat permukaan bumi dekat atas ni. Actually, we already know what is the gravitational earth, okay, gravitational field strength dekat permukaan bumi kan. Kita tahu dia adalah sebenarnya 9.81 meter per second. But now because we need to calculate, soalan B, this one soalan A, we need to calculate. So just masukkanlah that value. So mass still the same. And then R square is the radius of the earth. Then you should be able to get 9.8 meter per second. Eh, cuba tekan dapatkah value tu?
Dapat, miss.
Dapatkan 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, for the value of the mass here, okay, selalunya untuk gravitational constant, this one memang akan dibagi dalam list of constant. Okay, miss sudah upload dalam GC list of constant dengan list of formula yang dibagi semasa exam. Okay, tetapi mass of the earth, miss perasan dalam list of constant tu dia tidak bagi. So mass of the earth, mass of the planet, mass of the moon, mass of the sun. So ketiga-tiga ni value tidak dibagi. So this one usually dia akan bagi dalam soalan. So kalau dia bagi dalam soalan macam ni, kamu kena follow value tu yang dibagi dekat dalam soalan. Sebab akan ada sedikit perbezaan. Okay, dalam soalan tutorial kamu, mass of the earth dia terus bagi 6 eksponen 24. Dia terus bundarkan. So kamu gunakan value yang dibagi ya. Jangan yang kamu ingat sebab mungkin akan salah. Nanti kalau kamu buat tutorial question, kalau kamu gunakan this value, kamu akan dapat jawapan akhir tu akan ada sedikit berbeza lah. So kalau kamu ikut value yang diberikan, should be kamu akan dapat jawapan yang sama. Okay, any questions so far?
Tera miss.
Tera miss.
No miss.
No miss.
Okay, jelas lah semua kan. So kamu boleh kamu boleh gunakan kedua-dua formula untuk force, okay, gravitational force FG dan gravitational field strength AG. So mesti tahu beza kedua-dua, okay, kedua-dua term ni. Satu adalah force, satu adalah strength. Dia tidak sama ataupun lebih senang kita panggil dia acceleration untuk AG, the second one. Okay, so macam yang Miss cakap tadi, we will do quizzes. So semua boleh, wait. Semua boleh buka quizzes. And then, how do I start this? And then masukkan code ni. Let me stop presenting first. Okay, ada 7 soalan sahaja. Soalan tidak susah pun. But you can try. Okay, so semua boleh nampak kod dekat screen?
Nampak, Miss.
Okay.
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh
cuba masuk ah. Okay, setiap soalan Miss assign tidak lama masa dalam 30 saat je. Ada yang 45 saat sebab dia adalah soalan simple. Okay, ada lagi yang mau masuk? 45 now. Okay, sekarang kita ada 54. I think boleh start sudah. Ada lagi kak yang mau masuk? Wait, let me check first. How many? 72. Okay, Miss Tala. So yang lain, sorry lah yang dah dapat masuk. Maybe lain kamu slow sikit. Okay, let me start.
We have therefore between two body in the mirror. Does not depend on the sum of their mass, the distance between them. The gravitational constant.
Siapa salah ni awal?
The explanation is the gravity near the surface of the Earth. Very. Oh, where's the color? Wait. The universal gravitational constant is. Universal gravitational constant.
Itu jawaban soalan tiga.
Apa
dia? Tidak ada, soalan tiga ada jawaban sama.
Nanti kita bincang.
Together within two spherical bodies, if the distance between them be out into outer space, which of the following through the body is moving away from the Earth. If the mass weight decreases, the Earth if mass remains constant,
We could focus now.
Huh? Also, then, if the radius of the Earth were pushing its mass remaining the same, the electron. Huh? Ah, what were you? Lug, the mass remaining the same.
Oh, Jason sudah siap jawab. Vivian pun sudah, Hafizie sudah, Chong pun sudah, Hisham, Saidatul sudah, Awel pun sudah.
Ish, where is inverse be?
Pertanyaan aku
Kalista dengan
pertanyaan aku
apa? Itu ada saatnya aku menanya. Kalista dia aku cakap sama kau.
Dan boleh jawab kah?
Miss hilang lain miss the out.
Aku ini the out. Okey, dia pala. Tak pala kalau dia ada lain.
Jason ba. Hebat. Ha? Okay. Hah? Cari ke situ. Nomor berapa aku?
Let's see.
13.
Okay, Diana ni sudah siap ke? Ada kita mah. Shena, Dayang. Let me see siapa lagi yang belum. Kathy Dora. Kathy Dora ada lagi belum? Siapa ayam ni? Aduh, cantik-cantik nama dia bagi tu tak ayam. Shena. Okay, Kalista dapat. Alicia Shazwani pun tidak. Okay, kita tunggu kejap lagi. Okay, semua jawab sekarang ni. Yang lain ni sudah ter-out. Dayang, Kalista, Alter, Berens, Alicia, Akil, Shazwani. Shena? Ayam, bila mau habis jawab ni? Ada lagi. Okay, Miss Enkan boleh? Ada Adakah lagi yang belum habis jawab? Can I end this one?
Boleh.
Boleh?
Boleh, Jamis.
Boleh, Miss.
Kalau dia end, dia jadi apa? Sorry lah, Miss ni tidak. Okay, let me, kita end dulu. Are you sure you want to end? Okay, so now, wah, tahniah Jason, Diana, Jason, Suraya and Vivian. So ni tiga yang teratas lah. Maksudnya 100% betul kan ni? Okay, so boleh nampaklah dekat sini. Mana soalan yang kamu salah. This one, Miss tidak perlu bagilah dengan kamu. Okay, baik, kita boleh nampak Jason, Suraya, Vivian, Chong, semua betul. Sekali lagi, Fahima, who else? I think that's it. So ada 4 orang, semua betul. Susahkah soalan dia? Apa kamu tidak baca betul-betul?
Ada yang tricky lah tadi.
Ada yang tricky juga. Okay. Kita tengok soalan di sini. Okay, so first of all, the gravitational force between two bodies in the universe does not depend on which one? Soalan dia, jawapan dia?
The sum of their masses.
The sum of their masses. Okay, sebab gravitational force adalah the product of the masses. So distance, yes. Product, yes. Gravitational constant, yes. So the sum of the masses. Oh, ada juga yang salah. 28 orang salah. Okay, second one. A body is sent out into outer space. Which one of the following statements is true about this body as it is moving away from the Earth? So, moving away from the Earth. Which one yang betul? This one, right? So,
mass remains
its
constant.
Mass remains constant, but its weight decreases. Okay, mass sentiasa sama, tapi weight kita akan berbeza sebab weight kita adalah dalam Newton. Okay, dipengaruhi oleh gravitational force. Okay, next one. Okay, the gravitational force between two spherical bodies is 2F. So if the distance between them is double, the gravitational force will be. So this one tadi Miss ada explain kan? So kalau kita doublekan, kalau initial force dia adalah F, kalau kita doublekan dia akan jadi 1 over 4F. But now initial dia adalah 2F. Now kita doublekan, dia akan jadi 1 over 2F. Okay, the gravitational force akan jadi 1 over 2 of the initial force. Okay, next one. The gravitational field is directed. Okay, towards the Earth. Ada juga yang salah, 6 orang. Dia main hantam kan ni? Towards the Earth. Okay, next one. Deacceleration due to gravity near the surface of the Earth. So near the surface of the Earth is this one. Where is directly? No, constant. Okay, constant, yes. Soalan dia, jawapan dia B kan? So kalau dekat surface, dia adalah constant. So it's independent of altitude. Ya kah? Apa jawapan dia tu lah?
Jawapan dia inversely with the square, miss.
Oh, actually no. Actually varies inversely with the square of the distance from the center of the Earth. Okay, sorry. Jawapan dia this one. Varies inversely with the square of the distance from the center of the Earth. Okay, so soalan yang keenam, if the radius of the Earth were to shrink by 1%, its mass remaining the same, the acceleration due to gravity will
increase.
Okay, dia punya mass still sama, tetapi radius dia kurang. Okay. So last one, okay, this one actually soalan bonus. Okay, the universal gravitational constant is this one, 6.61 exponent negative 11. Dia negative 11 lah, bukan exponent 11. So mungkin ada yang 20 salah ni, dia pergi, dia nampak je ni, oh dia terus jawab this one. Okay, but overall, good job. Rasanya, okay lah kamu, I think you guys are in the pressure. Bila quizzes ni rasa macam pressure. So that's why ada yang main hantam je. Okay, wait. Let me stop presenting. Okay, so untuk chapter 7, okay, Miss plan kita akan habiskan minggu ni lah. Miss sudah siapkan semua video untuk semua subtopik. Subtopik 7.2 and 7.3. Okay, dan minggu depan kita akan masuk chapter 8. Okay, video tu nanti Miss akan bagi. Miss sudah upload dekat YouTube. So, I will give you the link later. So, kamu just tengoklah video tu, lengkapkan nota kamu. Okay, please lah. Miss susah lah mau paksa kamu kan mau tengok video. Ada alasan yang lupa apa semua tu. That is out of my control, but that's the only way kamu boleh belajar sebenarnya, dengan tengok video. Okay, Miss tidak dapat mau reply WhatsApp kamu 24 jam, mau ajar kamu tidak. That's why Miss buat video untuk menyenangkan. So hopefully kamu boleh master this chapter 7. Okay, chapter 7. Okay, any subject, bukan sekadar tengok video terus pandai, kena buat latihan. So nanti please buat latihan soalan tutorial. Kalau kamu boleh jawab soalan tutorial tu, should be kamu okay sudah. Okay. And satu lagi before I forget, the UPS, UPS 2 nanti kita akan buat the week before cuti. Okay, ada 2 minggu lagi. Ada, so UPS 2, chapter 5, 6 and 7. 3 chapter. Okay, 5, 6 and 7. Nanti Miss akan bagi soalan revision. Okay, untuk pra-UPS. Okay, so hopefully kamu boleh faham lah untuk 7.1 ni. So any question you can ask me. 7.1. Ask me, okay?
UPS 2 tu bila, Miss?
Sorry, apa dia?
UPS 2 tu bila?
UPS, tarik dia. Wait, let me double check. Dia adalah minggu yang sebelum cuti. So tarikh dia 6 hari bulan 10. Which is hari yang sama yang kita buat sebelum ni, Rabu kan? So sama juga pukul 2 petang hingga 2.50. Okay? So ada sama juga 20 soalan, 3 chapter. That one nanti misalkan forward kepada kamu dia punya detail. Ada soalan lain?
Tiada miss.
Okay, jangan lupa siapkan assignment practical test ya, buat video tu. So that one, okay, untuk assignment, lambat hantar, Miss akan potong markah. Miss tidak akan, okay, tiada markah kesian untuk yang dia hantar besoknya. Ni bukan kerja macam biasa. Kerja macam biasa kamu boleh hantar 2-3 hari lambat. But this one assignment, tidak boleh hantar lambat. Maksudnya, due date yang minggu depan Jumaat tu mesti hantar sudah. Lepas daripada tu maka akan ditolak. Okay, so kena ingat lah untuk assignment. And okay, Jumaat ni kita tidak akan ada Google Meet sebab kita sudah buat hari ni. So misalkan bagi video saja. Okay, so kalau tiada soalan, I think that's all for today's class. Okay, I'll see you next time. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
You're welcome. Sorry, I
thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.